Hello! In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint your Gloomspite Gitz Snarlfang Riders. We'll be painting quickly and efficiently to get your models looking great on the battlefield in no time at all. The first thing that we've done is undercoat our model, and for this colour scheme, we've used Grey Sear. The paints you'll need are on the screen now. The great thing about this guide is that it's using just 10 paints. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. The first paint we'll be using is Black Legion. We'll be picking out the buckle, leather, cloth, inside the Gitz mouth and claws, as well as the nose and inside of the mouth. If you get Black Legion onto any areas where you don't want it, that's okay. Just tidy it up using Grey Sear. We'll be using Black Legion straight out of the pot. It is easier to put down the darker contrast paint first. The reason for this is that if you apply your light contrast first and then your dark contrast, it's a lot harder to tidy it up. This is because the pigments are a lot stronger, so you'll have to go straight back to the base coat first. Our second paint will be Blood Angel's Red, and we'll be using this on the shield, the leather straps, as well as the eyes for the Snarlfang, as well as the Git. A nice trick here for applying the Blood Angel's Red. Once you've done the first layer, just apply it again into the recesses, and this will help to give some really nice, natural shading. As you can see, Blood Angel's Red is a very vibrant red, and it really covers the details nicely. Remember that when dotting the eyes, a good trick is to hold your breath. This will help to steady your hand when placing the paint bristles onto the eyes. Blood Angel's Red is a fantastic acting contrast paint. This is because it pulls away from the raised areas and collects in the recesses, helping to give some natural shading. For our next paint, we'll be using Snakebite Leather. We'll be using this to pick out the Snarlfang as well as the arrow feathers. I've loaded up my brush and applied it all over the Snarlfang. If the paint starts to pool anywhere, don't worry. All you need to do is dry off your brush and then soak up the pooling with the dry bristles. The reason for applying Black Legion becomes apparent here. This is because Snakebite Leather is a lot lighter contrast. This means that if we get any of the Snakebite Leather onto the Black Legion, we don't have to worry at all. However, if you feel like you've done too much, you can always just tidy back up with Black Legion. Our next stage is Wildwood, and for this we'll be using it to paint the tunic, arrows, Snarlfang ears, mane and tail. Just take your time when painting the tunic. If you get any of the Wildwood onto other areas where you don't want it, you can always just tidy it up with the previous layers. We'll be using the Wildwood just to darken certain areas of the Snarlfang, focusing on the top areas of the mane and over the ears, across the ridge of the back, and then halfway up the tail. The reason why we're doing this is that it adds character to the Snarlfang and helps to individualize your models. Our next paint will be Screamer Pink, and we'll be using this to pick out the Snarlfang's gums and tongue and the Gitz tongue as well. As you can see here, picking out the gums of the Snarlfang is a bit tricky, so just remember to thin out your paint nicely and take your time when picking out the gums. If you make any mistakes, you can just tidy up by using Grey Sear and then reapplying Snakebite Leather. If you get any Screamer Pink onto the Snarlfang's muzzle, don't worry about this. You can easily just tidy it up by reapplying Grey Sear and then Snakebite Leather. We are now more than halfway through our painting guide, and our next paint is going to be Gut Ripper Flesh, and we're going to be using this to pick out the Gitz skin. As always, just take your time when applying the Gut Ripper Flesh over the skin areas. Once you've done the first coat, just apply a second coat of it into the recesses. This will help to give the skin some really nice natural shading. Gut Ripper Flesh is a nice vibrant green that helps to bring your Gitz to life. We will now use Ushabti Bone, and we'll be picking out all the teeth and then the bone details on the model. Again, just take your time when picking out the teeth on the Snarlfang as well as the Git. If you make any mistakes, just tidy up using the previous layers that we've shown you. If you get lost where all the bone details are, just remember to check the box art. For this guide, We've also picked out the bow on the Gitz back in a shabty bone as well. We are now going to focus on doing the metallic details, and for this we're going to be using lead belcher. This will be one of the more tricky bits of painting the model, so just remember to take your time when going around all the previously painted areas. A good tip here is to use a brush that you are very comfortable with. This will help when applying the paint onto the details. If you get lost where any of the metallic details are, just remember to check the box art. As you can see here, we've picked out any of the armor bits on the Gitz helmet, as well as the rim of the shield, and the spikes on the leather straps of the Snarlfang, as well as picking out any buckles that we see. We've picked out the armor pieces on the Gitz torso, as well as the belt across his waist. Once you are done with lead belcher, just remember to change your water pot, because you don't want to get any of those metallic flakes into the rest of your paints. It's time to move to the shading phase, and for this we'll be using non-oil. We are going to be shading the metal areas as well as the black leather. We will also wash over the fur that we haven't painted yet, and this is on the helmet as well as across the belt buckle, and this will help to give it a nice grey tint. We will then apply non-oil into the recesses of the Gitz skin. Just take your time when applying it into the recesses of the Gitz skin. For our last stage, we'll be using Screaming Skull, and we'll be dry brushing it as a highlight over selected areas of the Snarlfang. If you want to know any more information about dry brushing, just remember to check out our Essentials Paint videos in the description. I'll be focusing the dry brush highlight just over the raised areas of the Snarlfang's fur. What this will do is make the Snarlfang's fur really pop and allow it to be the focal point on the battlefield. You can do as little or as much of the dry brush as you want at this point. A good place to focus this on are the paws, as well as around the muzzle, and any other raised areas that you can find. And there we are, with that dry brush complete, our Snarlfang Rider has come to life. With your Gloomspite Gitz Snarlfang Rider finished, he is now ready for battle in the mortal realms. You can see that our model is based in Armageddon Dunes, but you can base it in any color you like. If you want to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video on how to base your models. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we see you next time. Bye-bye!